We are going to look at two different applications to apply the social surplus concept. The first is a unit tax. So before we apply the concept, we have to understand how a unit tax works. And let's do that by noting that what a unit tax does is place a wedge between the buyer price, which I'm calling PB, and the seller price, which I'm calling PS. And the difference between the two of them is the tax. So PB equals PS plus T, or the seller's price is the buyer's price less the tax. The reason you need to understand this is you can only represent in a graph either the seller price, which we're representing over here, or the buyer price, which we're representing over here. The same economics is going on in both graphs, but the representation is different. When you represent the seller price, the demand curve does not stay fixed because the demand curve is in terms of the buyer price, so you have to translate the demand curve as the seller price plus the tax. When you represent the buyer price, it's the supply curve that shifts. So you have to understand what it is that you're plotting on these axes and do the analysis accordingly. You have three different controls here. The tax control may be the easiest one to understand, so I'm going to set the tax back to zero. And when you do that, you have supply and demand curves as you normally see them. Now let's start increasing the tax. In this picture, the effect of the tax is to shift the demand curve down. In this picture, the effect of the tax is to shift the supply curve up. And the shift amount is the amount of the tax. So there you have that. You have two other controls. So let's get this back to zero. One control affects the demand elasticity. You can make demand more elastic at the equilibrium. The equilibrium doesn't change, but the elasticity of demand changes. So you can increase elasticity or you can decrease elasticity of demand at the equilibrium. You can also change the elasticity of supply. You can make supply more elastic, or you can make supply less elastic at the equilibrium. And what you should be doing in this analysis is, as you impose the tax, ask what happens to the equilibrium when you change the demand elasticity. If we make demand more elastic, look what's going to happen. Focus both on the price and the quantity in this picture. If demand is more elastic, the buyer price does not go up by as much. More of the tax is borne by the sellers. It turns out the quantity falls even more. So I make the tax demand more elastic, quantity falls even more. I make it less elastic, quantity doesn't fall so much. I gotta stay clicking on the same side there. Likewise, if I make supply more elastic, so let's make supply. Now the buyer price goes up. More of the tax is borne by the buyers as supply gets more elastic. And again, as you make supply more elastic, the quantity goes down more. Who bears the tax depends on both the demand elasticity and the supply elasticity. It's not a correct statement that the tax is entirely passed through. That depends on the demand elasticity and the supply elasticity.